This video is over factoring special trinomials, and that's exactly how the textbook defines it, as special trinomials. In my mind, there's nothing special about these trinomials. You do them the exact same way as you've done before. So there's no new techniques involved. They just might look a little bit different. So I have a few examples that I want to go over, but remember, this works just the way that we factored the trinomials the last couple of days in class. Okay, so the first example that we see here, we can see that this one is in descending order. It has no common factors, and of course there's three terms. So therefore, it is a trinomial. So at first glance, there's nothing special about this, and there isn't. We'll see the special case when we actually already factor it just like we typically do. Okay, so I'm gonna set up my two sets of parentheses. Factors of 9, I have 3 times 3 or 1 times 9. So I'm just going to start with the ones that are closest together, so 3p times 3p. Looking at my last, I of course have a q times q. Factors of 49 is 7 times 7 or 1 times 49. Starting with the ones that are closest together here, it gives me 7 times 7. If I do outside, that gives me a 21pq. Inside gives me a 21pq. And if I do both of these are negative, that gives me a negative 42pq, which is exactly what we're looking for in the middle. So I need to do a negative and a negative. And if I double check my last sign, negative 7q times negative 7q does give me a positive 49q squared. Now, the reason that this is classified as a special trinomial is if we look at it in further investigation, we know that our factors are identical. So, if we ever have identical factors, then we can actually factor them just a bit farther. We can condense them down and say, this is my factor squared. So that's why this one is classified as a special trinomial. So if it's ever identical factors, just condense it down and put it as that factor squared. Okay, my next example of a special trinomial. The reason that this one is classified as special is because normally we have something that looks like ax squared plus bx plus c. So our terms are x squared and x and a constant term. This one's a little bit different because it's not x squared and it's not x, but it works out factoring just the way a normal trinomial factors. So that's why, again, in my mind, I don't necessarily think of it as a special trinomial. Okay, confirming our other steps, it's in descending order. I have no common factors, so I can set up my trinomials. Factors of 3 are 1 times 3. Factors of w to the 4th, well, that will be w squared times w squared. Moving on to my last, factors of 4 are 1 times 4 and 2 times 2. Let me start with the ones that are closest together. So outside gives me a 2w squared. Inside gives me a 6w squared, and I'm looking to add or subtract these to give me a 4w squared. Well, if I do positive 6 minus 2, that gives me a positive 4w. So I do a positive 6 and a minus 2. I double check my last sign. Positive times negative gives me negative, and so therefore this is my factoring here. So the only reason that this guy is special is because it's not a squared and then a single guy. But anything that has three terms can always be factored just like a typical trinomial. Okay, and then my last example of a special trinomial. So this one is classified as special is because it's got two variables up front. But again, it factors the exact same way as we are used to. So confirm, it's in descending order. We have no common factors. So let's go ahead and set up our two sets of parentheses. I'm gonna do an m in my first two places because that's what's going to give me my m squared and my n squared. Now let's look at my actual coefficients. So I can use 1 times 6 or 2 times 3. Let me start with my closest ones together. Over here with 12, 1 times 12, 2 times 6, 3 times 4. Let me start with 3 and 4, but I'm going to do a 3 here and a 4 there to confirm that I don't have any common factors in the parentheses. Outside gives me an 8mn. Inside gives me a 9mn, and I can add or subtract those to give me a negative 1mn, which is what I see here in the middle, if I have a negative 9 plus 8. Okay, so I need to find my 3s and make it a negative because that gives me my negative 9. And then on the outside, that gives me a positive 8. Confirm my last term. Negative times positive does give me negative, so therefore I have factored this trinomial. Again, it factors just like a normal trinomial. The only thing different is that we have two variables in our first term. So the book classifies all three of these cases as special trinomials. To me, it's just trinomials continued. There's nothing special about them because we factor them the exact same way as we normally factor. The only thing special is in that first case where when we have identical factors, we need to make sure that we condense them and put them as a factor squared. And so here ends this video.